Hey guys, welcome back. Thanks for joining us today on The King of Random. In the past, we've done several experiments with dry ice, and we've had two viewers give us suggestions of other things to try with the dry ice. Daniel Mileage asks, how does liquid nitrogen compare to a cooling bath of acetone and dry ice? YouTube user Like Woe says, put dry ice in your backyard foundry. So Like Woe and Daniel Mileage, today we're going to be doing two experiments using extreme heat and extreme cold. The first thing we're gonna try is using some dry ice and acetone to make a super cooled liquid that you can use for some experiments if you're having a hard time getting some liquid nitrogen. Dry ice is extremely cold. It's approximately 109.3 degrees Fahrenheit below zero. Acetone doesn't freeze until 139 degrees Fahrenheit below zero, so we can put dry ice in acetone. It will super cool the liquid down to the temperature of the dry ice, but it won't freeze. We don't just want to mix the two together, so first we're going to use this cup to create a barrier between the acetone and the dry ice. For our first step, let's take a drill and poke some holes in our cup. I've poked a lot of holes into this cup because I want the acetone to be able to flow in and out of it easily. Next, we're going to break up some of the dry ice and spread it all around the outside of the cup. All right, now load these all up, roll around our cup. Our glass bowl is whining. That's the dry ice vibrating in very small movements all around the glass. Just sounds like it's complaining. The next step is to pour your acetone down into the bowl, and it should fill the cup as well as all the way around the dry ice. Just pour some directly into the cup to make sure it's getting in there. There you go, lots of bubbling going on. I'm gonna try adding a little bit more dry ice as well. Some of it seems to have sublimed off from the heat of the acetone. All right, now we have a bath of extremely cold acetone. That's fun. And in the middle, because we have the holes in the cup, we have a spot that doesn't have any dry ice in it, so we don't have to worry about whether things are coming in contact with the dry ice. All right, watch what happens when I stick the tip of my glove into the acetone. Oh, that's very, very cold. It actually makes the nitrile of my glove get a little bit stiff just from freezing it so much. Let's see what happens if we freeze a carrot. Please note, never use this cold acetone bath on anything you're going to eat. Acetone is toxic and not safe for consumption. All right, carrot into extremely cold acetone. This acetone should be about 109 degrees below zero Fahrenheit. Here goes. It's boiling in a similar manner to the liquid nitrogen when you pour it in. The heat from the carrot is heating up the acetone quite a bit. Hopefully the dry ice is keeping it nice and cold. Just set that in there for a minute. All right, our carrot looks pretty good and frozen. What I'm gonna do at this point is take it out and smash it with a hammer to see if it shatters the way we expect a really frozen piece of produce to do. Quickly, before I try that, let's make a control by smashing an unfrozen carrot. 3, 2, 1. That kind of exploded a little bit more than I expected it to. Carrots aren't super squishy, so I guess it makes sense. We've tried smashing the unfrozen carrot. Let's see how the frozen carrot handles. Ooh, listen to that. That is not the sound of normal carrot. 3, 2, 1. Oh my gosh. That is a very frozen carrot. Holy cow. That sent shards. I mean, the unfrozen carrot like broke apart, but this like explode. Listen to that. That's a carrot. That is shattered to high heaven right there. Kablooey. That is ice carrot. Now we know what happens if you freeze a carrot in acetone that's over 100 degrees below zero. Next, I want to try an experiment with a rubber band. When rubber gets too cold, it loses its elasticity, meaning it won't stretch out, but it also means if it is stretched out, it won't contract back in, and that's what we're going to try and do today. What I'm going to do is take this rubber band, fit it on the end of the bamboo skewer and stretch it out, and while it's stretched, I'm going to dip it into our freezing cold acetone. Let's see what happens. little bits of carrot floating around in there, but that shouldn't cause any problems. That's probably pretty good and cold already. It's stopped bubbling. Let's take it out and see what happens if I let go of the rubber band. Look at that. The stretched out portion is staying stretched out, and then as it warms back up, it regains its elasticity as it warms back up. This time I'm gonna see if I can pull the rubber band out and immediately try and bend it and see if it will break. In theory, it should be able to get cold enough for that, but it might just warm up too fast and I'm not able to get it. All right, let's see what I can do here. There it goes! Snapped a rubber band in half, and now it's already warmed up enough that it's starting to be stretchy again. Let's try that again. Broken. I think at this point, the responsible thing to do is to put the whole rubber band ball in and see what happens. Hopefully the acetone is getting in between the rubber bands and down into the middle, so it's really freezing it all the way through. All right, let's see if I can take this out and see if it has any bounce left to it at all. I bet it doesn't really have any. That sounded like a rock. Put this back in for just a second in case it's warmed up. Then I'm gonna try hitting it with a hammer. 1, 2, 3. Well. Bits of it broke off. I did shatter some parts. You can see little destroyed bits of rubber band just sort of sitting around. There are impact marks where the hammer hit, and I think as this warms up, this is gonna start peeling away a lot more. As one last experiment with our freezing cold acetone and dry ice, I'm gonna see what happens if I pour a little bit of water into it. Genuinely have no clue what to expect here. So I think the water dispersed in the acetone, but it also froze, so I'm pretty sure what we're seeing in there are tons of separated individual little ice crystals. I'm gonna pour some more in. That just kind of builds up on the sides here. Weird, slushy. I'm guessing that's a mix of acetone and water. It certainly smells like acetone. Ooh. That is spraying everywhere, isn't it? Now we've tested making a cooling bath that takes acetone down to over 100 degrees below zero. Let's see what happens if we take dry ice and put it in our backyard foundry. Dry ice is composed of carbon dioxide, so it's possible that as it heats up and starts turning into a gas, it will put out the flame. That's one of the things we're gonna find out. And if it doesn't put out the flame, let's see what it will do. Our foundry's nice and hot. Let's see what happens when we put in our dry ice. Looking at it so far, it's smaller. It's still extremely cold, of course. Other than that, it doesn't look like it's doing anything really special from the heat. The fire in the forge doesn't seem to be affected by the carbon dioxide. I think that there's enough flow from the pressure of the propane that it just blows any excess carbon dioxide right out the top. Let's see if it makes any difference to put the lid on. There's our dry ice down in the foundry with the lid on. It looks like it's glowing orange, but I'm almost positive that's just from the ambient light lighting it up. Well, there it is. It hasn't seemed to change much, except that it's smaller. So I'd say the heat does make it dissipate faster, but nothing else is really happening to it. Well, I'm gonna try something else. I'm gonna try heating up these tongs until they're glowing red hot, and then touch that directly to the dry ice. All right, let's see what happens. Well, not a lot, really. Not a lot happened. I thought it would do a lot more. I thought the red hot metal might melt its way through the dry ice, kind of like it does with normal ice, but it just cooled off the metal and barely left a dent in the dry ice. Let's throw the rest of it in, see what happens. Well, all of our dry ice is gone. It didn't put out the flame. It didn't put off a lot of vapors like it does if you put it in hot water. It just sort of sublimated into nothingness. That whole block took about 10 minutes to disappear in our furnace, which is much faster than if you just left it sitting on the counter, but it's not very enjoyable. After pouring all of that water into our super cooled acetone bath, something interesting has happened. It's turned into a slush. So I think this is about half water and half acetone. So I'm gonna scoop it out, put it on a brick, and light it on fire. Not entirely sure what's making it bubble like that. Here goes. Oh, it's actually on fire. It's just acetone burning, so it's very clear. It's hard to see. But that is burning right now. Burning snow. You don't see that every day. It's still really cold. It's on fire, but it's freezing cold. Like, if I touch part of it, it's very cold to the touch, but it's on fire. It's freezing cold and on fire at the same time. That was freezing my hand and burning my hand. Different parts of my finger at the same time. Oh, and now our acetone is all just running off and pouring off. And we've used this brick for some colored smoke powder before, and the acetone has been pulling that off of the brick, and so we're getting this pink stain as it runs. There you have it, two experiments using dry ice. One, a method of making an extremely cold liquid bath using acetone. The other, putting dry ice into our backyard foundry. With the acetone bath, we were able to supercool rubber and produce, and both of them became very brittle and lost all their elasticity when they were completely frozen in the acetone. With the dry ice in the foundry, it turned into gas faster than it normally would if it were just sitting out on the counter, but it wasn't really very entertaining. Nothing spectacular happened. The CO2 wasn't enough to put out the fire. It just kind of disappeared. A special shout out to Daniel Mileage and Like Woe for your suggestions on what we should try. Check your YouTube inbox, we're sending you $25. If you have any ideas for any experiments or projects you want us to try, let us know down in the comments. If we end up using your idea, we'll send you $25. Acetone is easily available at most hardware stores, so this is an experiment you probably can try at home. Just be sure you wear protective gloves and eyewear at all times. Thanks for joining us today for these projects, and we look forward to the next one. Talk to you then. It's bouncy again. This is cleanup. Don't light on fire. 3, 2, 1. Hang on, I'm gonna put my safety glasses on.
Hey guys, did you know that we're on Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook as well? All at The King of Random, and every platform has a different purpose. So go scroll through the histories, check out what we're doing. I'll see you there.